Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see the classification of section. The sections which are divided as plastic, compact, semi-compact and slender. So let's see them one by one, what are they and how you can classify them. See, first of all, before starting the classification, let me tell you some theory about this. See, the buckling of a section may occur due to axial force, moment or shear. This concept you should remember. For example, I have a column here like this. There is a slender column here. So the buckling of this column will be like this, either this side or this side. Okay. So why this buckling happens? See, this buckling of column or any section occurs or happens due to axial forces, means whatever is the axial force coming over this, then the moment, is there any moment in this, and the shear forces, that is the transverse forces. So because of this, there will be buckling of section. This point you remember. Then the second point, the local buckling can be avoided by limiting width to thickness ratio of the elements. So if you want to avoid this buckling, what you can do, you can limit this ratio. Which ratio? The width to the thickness ratio. Now, if I give you the example of a particular section like this, for example, you have a section like this. This is an I section, okay? So, this one will be your thickness, this one will be your depth, and this one will be the width, okay? So, if you limit this ratio B by T, then there are chances that your section will not buckle. There are chances that your section will not buckle because of limiting this ratio. So that is what this sentence says. Now I will divide these sections. See, the classification of section will completely depend upon this ratio only. Which ratio? B by T ratio. I'll explain you how it is related to this only. See, the first type of classification is the class 1, and that is known as plastic cross sections or just plastic. See, we have classified the section according to their slenderness ratios, or you can simply say the ratio of B by T, width to thickness ratios. We will divide those sections. Okay, so the first type of section is known as class 1, or it is the plastic cross section. Okay, so what is this? See, the plastic cross sections are those which can develop their full plastic moment, that is MP, and allow sufficient rotation at or above this moment so that redistribution of bending moments can take place in the structure until complete failure mechanism is formed. Now, what does that mean? See, it says the plastic cross sections are those sections which can develop their full plastic moment. Means they will go up to the plastic. See, I will explain this thing here. See, this one, there is a ratio here. See, this one is plastic zone, this one is compact zone, this one is semi-compact zone, and last one is slender zone. For example, your B is something and your T is something. I'll take certain values, okay? Your width is say 500, okay? And your thickness is 10. So what will be the value here? The value will be 50. That is our first case. Let us assume, okay? Now, there is another chance that your B by T will be like this. For example, your B is 1000. I'm just giving an example, okay? And your thickness is 10. So what will be the ratio here? 100. Now observe this. See, the in first case, your width is 50. So it will, for example, if it is a channel section, it will look like this. Okay? If it is an angle section, I'll draw both. It is like this. Okay? And this one is 500. This one is 500, and this one, this thickness only, I'm talking about only thickness, okay? This one is 10, okay, in both the cases. Now, what I did, I took this section. This one is 1000, and this one is only 10, like this. Means this size will get increased. So, if ratio is like this, width to thickness ratio, or you can take another example. For example, this one is like this. If it is a simple rod like this, and its width is something and its thickness is something. So what happened here? it the section is getting in which zone? It is getting in plastic zone. So if you observe this carefully, moment capacities of section will be on x-axis and the moments will be on y-axis. So if you go on increasing this ratio, see this ratio is known as beta, okay? So this if you go on increasing the ratio, your section will again thinner and thinner and thinner, means your section will become slender. So if you go on increasing this ratio, your big section will become slender and slender, more slender means. First it will be a plastic one, then it will be a compact one, semi-compact, and last it will be in slender zone, okay? Now, so in plastic cross sections, what happens? The plastic moment, whatever is the moment generated in that section, that will be generated up to its full capacity, and sufficient rotation will also be allowed, and that is nothing but your first section, that is plastic cross section, and it is also known as class 1 section. So for this, as you can see the diagram, you have to remember this diagram, okay? This should be drawn if it is asked in the exam to explain these things. So it says B by T is less than or equal to beta 1. Check it whether it is less than or equal to. See, for first your B by T value will lie here. If your B by T value lie here, then it will be in the range of B1, beta 1 to beta 2. For example, see, if I am saying that my B by T value lies in between, this B by T value lies in between beta 1 and beta 2. So what does that mean? If my value, this B by T value is lies between, this is nothing but your beta, okay? So your beta value lies between beta 1 and beta 2, that means your section is compact. If it lies between beta 2 or beta 3, then it is known as semi-compact. Or you can write like this also. If your beta value is greater than beta 1 but less than beta 2, then it will be a compact. If it is greater than beta 2, less than beta 3, then it is semi-compact, and so on. Okay. So that is your first classification. Then let's see second one. Second one is class 2, that is known as compact cross section. Now what is compact? Compact cross sections are those which can develop their full plastic moment, but where the local buckling prevents the required rotation at this moment to take place. See, what does that mean? It will also develop the full plastic moment, but there will be certain restrictions about the rotation. So only, see, in first case what happened? In first case, there was full development of plastic moment and sufficient rotation was also allowed. But in case of second, that is class 2 or the compact section, full moment was developed, plastic moment was developed, but local buckling was prevented for the rotation, okay? So in short, you can say that my B by T value will lie in between. See, it will lie here. So it will lie in between like this. It will be greater than beta 2 and it will be less than beta. Sorry, it will be greater than beta 1 and it will be less than beta 2. Or you can see here in also in the diagram. Then let's see class 3 sections, semi-compact cross sections. Now how you will remember this? See, the semi-compact cross sections are those sections in which the stress in the extreme fibers should be limited to the yield stress. What does that mean? What is extreme fiber? For example, this is your section. I'll draw a section of I, okay? For example, this is your I section, okay? Let us assume that this is your I section. You can draw it properly. I have to just explain here. Now, see, this is your I section, okay? Now, what is extreme fiber here? The topmost layer here, the topmost or the bottommost layer from the neutral axis. For example, if this is your neutral axis, the topmost or the bottommost layer will be known as extreme fibers, okay? They should be limited to yield stress. You may have seen or you may have heard about the stress diagrams, okay? So that stress should be limited to what? Yield stress, that is Fy. Fy concept, you will learn this, what is Fy, in the next videos, okay? So it should be limited to Fy, that is yield stress, because local buckling would prevent the development of full plastic moment, because it will not allow this local buckling will not allow to go it up to plastic moment. It will not allow that. So there will not be any development of the full plastic moment, okay? Then such sections will be called as semi-compact sections, and these sections will only develop the yield moment. See, if you want to classify it like this, see, only up to this point they are going, and that is nothing but your MY, plastic, sorry, yield moment. They will not go up to this point. That is your plastic moment. Only sections, which sections, plastic and compact sections, will be going up to this point. That is plastic moment. And this section, this and this will not go up to this plastic moment. They will be up, taken only up to yield stress or below that. See, semi-compact will go up to what? Only yield moment will be generated up to this point only. And cylinder will be also less than this. Okay. Now, if you want to take in, if you want to talk in terms of beta 2 and beta 3, what it will be? See, its B by T value will lie in between beta 2 and beta 3. Means this beta 2, B by T value will be greater than beta 2 and it will be less than beta 3. That is what here it is written. Okay. Now, the last type of section, that is slender cross sections. See, the slender cross sections are those sections in which yield in the extreme fibers cannot be attained because of premature local buckling in the elastic range. Means this particular section, this slender section, will not go in the plastic zone. It will fail in the elastic zone itself. It will be in elastic range only. It will not go beyond that. See, it is below this point. Okay. So it means it is not going up to this point. Means it is not covering the plastic moment. It is going only going up to this, that is yield stress, or below that. Actually below that. So below that will be which zone? It will be an elastic zone. You have to remember this. It will be an elastic zone. Okay. So for this, if you want to define it in ITA terms, what it will be? Your B by T ratio will be what? It will be greater than beta 3. This will be greater than beta 3. Like this you can write, or in this way also you can write. It is one and the same. Okay, so there are four types of sections which you divide, and they are divided as plastic, compact, semi-compact and slender. In plastic, there will be full rotation, there will be full plastic moment generation. In compact, there will be moment generation, full plastic moment generation, but will not be any rotation. There will be certain restrictions. In semi-compact, let me show you. In semi-compact, there are chances of local buckling. That's why your moment will generate it up to only yield moment. It will not go up to beyond that. And in slender sections, what will happen? Due to the extreme fibers that are in the yield zone, they will attain the premature local buckling and they will be in the elastic zone only. So these are the four types of sections, or this is the classification of sections as plastic, compact, semi-compact and slender. Thank you.